Hi friends, let us see how to use a direct form FIR realization in solving a problem. So let us take up a problem. So the problem for today is given as h of z, that is a transfer function, given as 1 plus 3z inverse plus 2z raised to minus 3 minus 4z raised to minus 4. Okay, so now we have received this transfer function, and we have seen that there is only numerator, there is no denominator. That means this is an FIR filter which has all zeros to it. There is no poles. Poles are there, but they are all at origin, that is at z is equal to 0. Now, to solve this further, okay, we need to actually apply, let's say, I will say like h of z can be written as y of z by x of z, which is equal to 1 plus 3z inverse plus 2z raised to minus 3 minus 4z raised to minus 4, right? Now multiply both sides by xz, you will get yz over here, then you will get xz over here, plus 3 times of z inverse xz plus 2 times of z raised to minus 3 xz minus 4 times of z raised to minus 4 xz. Okay, so I multiplied both sides by xz. If I take inverse z transform, then I am going to get y of n equals to x of n plus 3. Now here z inverse, if I imply over here, it becomes x of n minus 1, that is 1 delay, plus 2 x of n minus 3, because there are 3 delays, minus 4 x of n minus 4, because there are 4 number of delays. Okay, so what we can see is, we see that the output depends on the input, then one delayed input, we have to delay the input thrice, and we have to delay the input 4 times, and then we have to add them all, correct? So there will be a summing block, because we gonna add the things. There will be a multiplier block, because we are going to have coefficients, constant coefficients to it, and we are going to have a delay block, because we need to have delays into it. So these 3 blocks will be there in the structure. Okay, now let us realize the structure. To realize the structure, I will consider first input as my x of n, and along with x of n the coefficient is 1, so that really does not matter. Okay, then I have to delay x of n by 1 unit. So I will delay it by 1 unit, and I am going to get your output as x of n minus 1. Now along with n minus 1, the multiplier factor that I have is 3. So I have 3. Okay, then I have to delay thrice. So this block will give me n minus 2, and there is no z raised to minus 2 term, so don't have to get this out. So I will just put another delay block, and this will be x of n minus 3, and now the multiplier with this is 2. Okay, then I have to delay it one more time, because there are 4 times of delays. So this is z raised to minus 1, and now this becomes x of n minus 4. Okay, and now the multiplier is minus 4. Don't write 4, retain the signs when you are moving in the forward direction. Now we need to add them all. So I will add these two guys first using a summing element. Okay, then I'm going to add these two guys again using a summing element, and then finally we are going to add them both, and this becomes my y of n. Okay, this is one way to draw the structure. That means I will draw the Z in the sequential order. There is one more way to draw the same structure, and the way is like this. We know that we are going to get X of N as my input, okay, which I'm going to delay, let's say by a factor of Z inverse, then again a factor of Z inverse, again a factor of Z inverse. Now I'm showing only till 3 points, okay. We know we want an output from X of N, which is having a multiplying factor of 1. Then we have a output from X of N minus 1, and the multiplying factor is 3. We don't have anything out from here because the multiplying factor is X of 2 is not there. That is 2 times of delay is not there. So we have a delay of 3, which is again having a multiplying factor of 2. So at this point, at this node, I have the X of N as X of N minus 1, which is delayed by 1. Here at this node, it is again X of N minus 2. And at this node, it is again X of N minus 3. Okay. Now, what we have to do? We need to add them. So we can add them by putting an adder over here and add them both. Again an adder over here and add them both, and further it will go ahead because there is one more block that is pending over here, okay, and then finally we will get Y of N. This is called as tapped structure. So we will pull out tabs in the main line and we get this tapped structure. There is nothing basic difference between this and this. This is just a way of representation. Normally, when people make an FIR filter, they normally use this structure. It does not make harm if you make this kind of structure. It is nothing wrong in that. But people prefer to use this type of structures when they are designing an FIR filters. So this is the solution of the problem. We started with H of Z. Okay, we started with H of Z. We have seen that how X of N's are related to Y of N. They are summed up, then they are multiplied by coefficient and they are delayed. So we have a delay block, we have a summing block and we have an amplifier block. And then we have to combine them in such a way that they will result into Y of N. And there are two basic types of structure that we can design. One is the lateral structure, okay, and one is the tapped structure, which we can design it in this form. So basically we will be using this type of structures rather than this type of structures, but there is nothing wrong in designing or drawing this type of structures for a direct form FIR filters. Thank you.